number one rated defensive team in the league. That's why they have the best record in the West.
And Anobi's first shot. He loves those corners.
Welcome to New York. This is what the people want to see.
Hart makes his move, kicks it out. And Anobi goes inside, pass to Hart, just gets it off in time as the shot clock expires. Good ball movement. Back to DiVincenzo. Nearly stripped by McDaniels. DiVincenzo gets it back. Inside pass. Anobi throws it down. Dante DiVincenzo on a helter-skelter play with the assist.
Watch here again. Shot clock winding down. DiVincenzo to the basket. And OG fumbles a little bit, catches it. And look at that finish.
Wants to give it back to him. Finds the corner. Good pursuit. DiVincenzo. Pass inside. Anobi. Second connection between those two. And the Knicks with their largest lead of the first half. Doesn't have a turnover. Inside Edwards. Hartenstein alters that. And Anobi running the floor. Catch goes inside and throws it down. And Anobi 9 points.
People moving. Talking about running the floor. We said to keep the pressure on. When you can get a stop, run the floor, and you'll get easy buckets because you've got players on this team that are willing passers on the break. And
said, Coach, I just ran out of talent. Runs it inside, feeds Anobi, another slam. Anobi once again moving without the ball. Brunson's got 9 assists. Rich playing some terrific team basketball at both ends. Brunson in the corner. Anobi hits a three. OG Anobi, 14 points. And the Knicks have blown it open here in the second, a 22-point lead. Ends in his debut. It
certainly is. The little things and, of course, the big things, like hitting the open corner three, which is a big part of this Knick offense.
Has scored 10. Brunson, Anobi, corner three. Got it! OG Anobi with his third three-pointer of the afternoon.
We've talked about OG Anunoby and all the things he brings. We'll continue to tell you, 43% from the corner three is a big number. You hear that from a lot of players.
Nice feed inside. Hartenstein kicks it back out. Randall wide open, connects on a three. What a methodical stroll to the basket there.
Very patient for a young player.
Julius Randall, 2 for 2 from downtown.
Thought it might be Randall.
Randall against Naz Reid, who just checked in. Tough shot. Randall won't get it. Gets it back. Puts it back up and in. Randall against Karl-Anthony Towns. Goes inside. Off balance and still knocks it home off the glass. Edwards goes inside. Throws it up high. And Anobi the rebound. Quick outlet. Knicks again look to push. And Anobi running the floor. Back to Randall. Randall lays it up and in. Brunson keeps his dribble alive. With Gobert in pursuit. Randall goes right at Anthony Towns, lays it up and in. It just overwhelms him with his strength. Randall has it. Tough fallaway shot. It's good. Oh, Julius Randall falling away. McLaughlin can't hit. Hart, another rebound. Hart pushes this time, coast to coast, blocked. But Randall right there. Edwards made a terrific defensive play, but Julius Randle fouls it up. Randle, guarded by McDaniels, drives, spins, shot is up, and good. Julius Randle, masterful move for the paint. Trying to get Anunoby for the last several years. Defends him well and throws it away. Here comes Brunson, ahead to Randle, inside, layup is good. OG Anunoby's defense forcing the turnover, and the Knicks back up by 8. 4 to shoot. Randall puts it up, puts it in as the shot clock expires. Julius Randle with a huge bucket, and the Knicks back up by 9.
Jalen Brunson is struggling to get it going offensively. It's Randall that has to take over. The value of having 2 all-star caliber scorers.
Finds Randall. Randall falling away. It's good. Julius Randle back-to-back.
One with the others not going. Boy, Julius Randle had it going from the first quarter on in this game. Gets the friendly bounce from the Garden rims.
Hart brings it back out. Randle drives. Randle inside. Count it and a foul. Julius Randle down the stretch with big time buckets.
And then here, when they needed a bucket the most, he takes it hard to the basket, goes through all the trees.
talked to both Barrett and Quickly yesterday, and they came early today to run through some sets. It's an open goal. Q knocks it down from T.O. Talked to both Barrett and Quickly yesterday, and they came early today to run through some sets. It's an open goal. Q knocks it down from T.O.
Identity is you just see R.J. side pick and roll action. Had Pirtle going to the basket, which collapsed the defense.
Donovan Mitchell has been spectacular during that stretch.
Oh, slam dunk with that nice little.
Did you see the fake pass?
His backcourt made at Kentucky.
No, he definitely does. Tyrese Maxey, a little fake right there. Just a little eye contact, but that's what you want to see as well.
Jakob gives it right back at the foul line. Rises up. Jumper doesn't go. Bats it to Barnes. Good job by Gary. Open three. Quickly.
Our assistant just passing the basketball. Great offensive rebound.
He is Caris LeVert. The other two names. Bogdan Bogdanovic. And Emmanuel Quickly as Pascal Siakam knocks down a three. At home. Shoots 34% from three. Open. You're going to give it. I'll take it. Raptors by two. In his fourth season out of Utah State, here's RJ. He's working hard, and that's what he can do. There could be a lot of congestion around traffic.
Although you know he can score. And look at RJ beating everyone down the floor. We mentioned that this team is that much faster with RJ and Quickly.
Well, over half of his time in the NBA has come off of the bench. RJ just right through traffic.
And you like how he's going to the rack. Nobody's going to stop him. That's two guys right there.
Gets... Boucher with a rebound. Gets it down to RJ. RJ attacking in traffic. Goes in, uses the offhand. You said it. There it is.
Again, not going to stop him. I miss it, but I'm not quitting. Go right back over there with one hand put back.
Foul line cut off by Allen. RJ. Entry pass. Quickly.
Rim, and you just see RJ just being patient, unselfish basketball, Quickly doing a nice job of hesitating.
Sends it to Pascal looking for Jakob. Quickly with it, under 10 of the shot clock. He's attacking, and the foul.
Have this mismatch we talked about, he can exploit these mismatches from the perimeter. Get to the basket, absorb the contact, get the fan. And he got the steal in a different way without putting himself in harm's way.
7-point game. RJ puts it on the deck. RJ leans in.
And that's what I like.
Schroeder finds Gary. Close out by Struess. RJ fires a three, and it's good from Mississauga.
And Matt, that is huge.
4 assists. So he's right there, and he's got more time to do damage. Merrill launching, wanted a call, was trying to create it. Backing in. Barrett muscling his way in. RJ's looking for the and one.
Kind of sort of matchup. He saw this is big chicken, as Shaq would say. Right down the lane, post up, using that man strength.
Merrill on him. Attacking. Floater, good. He's got 14.
Deontay George and Jordan Clarkson on the floor. You mentioned marketing, yet to take a shot. Here it is. It's up and good. And a three-point opportunity for the finisher. Nice strong move by Lowry. Jazz by two. Deontay strolls into front court to Simone. Cross court. Clarkson. Step back jumper. Right off the elbow. Got it. Beautiful. Back at 22 out of Duke.
And you saw them put the pressure on Luka Doncic early. At that time, the Jazz have to cover everything. Again, the ball finds Lowry Market.
You know what? Catch, shoot. In and out, the shot by Hardaway. JC. That first quick step, he drives off the glass and in. He just blew past Dwight Howell. And this shot by Powell. The Jazz getting it done on the defensive side. Walker sprints back into front court. Here's JC again on the lob up top. And Clarkson, that's what you call bang bang.
With Hardaway Jr. and Kyrie lead the charge.
Oh my! KO on a push in the back.
Well, JC just understanding where to put the ball and was in trouble here, right? You thought maybe he was trying to get a shot up.
Goes out to Walker, fires up a triple. Clarkson, he's been everywhere. Clarkson in the corner. Dribble drive, step back. That's a tough shot, T. No, that's money. Jazz had seven players in double figures against Miami. Doncic gave it up. Kyrie wasn't ready for it. Clarkson behind the back to Dunn.
That's why this team's doing so well. They take care of each other. Great defense here. Kyrie tries to ride with Clarkson, but...
JC against Hardaway Jr. over the shoulder. Wow, what a pass out. Oh, Markkanen drops the triple. And you know what, T? You just can call it sweet. Just sweet.
Jordan Clarkson, this is his seventh assist. And you can only do that if you know ahead of time where your guys are going to be. Beautiful kick out, catch and shoot.
Keontae George, guarded by Doncic. Here's JC. Shot clock hits seven. Takes the triple. Got it. Got it. Over. Kyrie Irving. Puts the ball back down on the floor. Swings to his right, back to his left. JC over the top. Olynyk. Bang! There's Olynyk. Right back to JC. He loves his shot. Got it.
Makes it look easy, doesn't it?
He sure does. You know, he pulls the string like a yo-yo. One away from the first triple-double since 2008. Clarkson, and he finishes it on the other end. 18 points for the Flame. Carlos Boozer, if you're watching, you know it's time.
It is time.
Here's George. Rises up. Got it! I think he just pointed to the far side of the floor. He goes, I nearly had one.
Nice job right there, just a catch and shoot, creating space by getting that ball low.
Slips and slides inside the three. He's got it! The futility!
There it is.
Ends tonight on New Year's Day, 2024.
There it is.
So making the return on a minutes restriction Saturday in Chicago. Embiid in the paint, and there's his first bucket. Since the quarter of that one, but gutted it out.
There's that duck in again from Joel.
Seeing what Oubre and Batum look like together. So far, so good. Embiid from outside. 6 for 7 from downtown. Embiid doubles. Skips out of it. Pat Bev from the corner. And it goes.
That's what the presence of Joel Embiid does automatically, just having him out on the floor.
Great catch and finish by Nico Batum.
Decent offensive rebounding team.
Rents his former backup, spinning away from Drummond. That's the Joel Embiid.
Well, hints of Hakeem Olajuwon right there. The fake middle that drops that baseline. Watch this again. Shoulder square. That is a pretty...
Embiid thought he was fouled. Here come the Bulls. Drummond lost it. Batum saves it to Oubre. Ahead to the big fella. Embiid lays it up and in. A lot on tap.
Too easy. Got to make sure that he doesn't take such a direct pass.
Embiid. Too easy. From the free throw line.
Watch this action again. Maxi leaves it for Joel.
So. 11-5-5 for the reigning NBA MVP so far tonight. First action in 11 days. Make it 13-5-5 for Embiid. Embiid. Licks. On the baseline. Joel has 15 in the first half tonight. He's glad they're finally listening. Embiid straight on triple. Make it 20 for Joel Embiid tonight.
Range in that trailer position. Tobias kicks it to him. Drummond thinking.
We'll do the next couple months. Drummond knocks it away from Embiid. Joel gets it back, fades away, and hits another.
A little frustrated. Watch this play again. Joel just taking what the defense gives him. I think you're correct.
I think so. DeMar DeRozan, unable to hit from distance. Joel scoops it to Maxey. Tyrese, fourth triple tonight.
Action with the outlet pass. Maxey gets it and goes. Phillips late getting out. Just happy.
Yeah,
but
just focus on that grab.
He's been really, really good. And most importantly, consistent. Ooh. Contact. If he would have went right up to the rim and had that confrontation, perhaps he'd be at the line.
Now he's trying to get it back to Joel. Embiid, floater 29 for Embiid tonight.
Clear. It's clearly there.
That is 10 assists for Joel after the Tobias buckets. Second triple-double of the season, and Embiid does it in style. The no-look to...
Foot point guard, soak it up, folks. The no-look. Tobias along the baseline. Duarte.
Knocked away by Terry Rozier.
Not that. That's good D by Terry right there.
Rookie out of San Diego State. This is now his eighth game with the Hornets. Hornets had to give him a call up from the Greensboro Swarm when Mark Williams went down. Terry Rozier, his first field goal. Another former Atlanta Hawk, Alex Len, into the ball game. And Len lost it.
Got
Hornets
ripped
with a steal.
Ish right there to take it.
Carey.
Oh, my.
Spins it in off the window on top of Herter.
Trey Lyles been in the league 8 years.
9 years.
Nine.
Can you believe that? JT takes his time. Nice. And spins it on top of Swipe of the Fox.
Nice.
This is our third game on this road trip in the state of California.
Swooping with the southpaw.
Carey. Oh, my goodness. He's nice to his mama.
Put any defensive unit you want in the game.
PJ saves the pass. Carey. Off of 1 foot, able to softly put it through.
And the wrong foot at that.
Bridges sneaks it up and in.
Use that good wide body.
So this is the largest lead of the game for Sacramento. And Terry cuts it down to five.
That little jump step to the right.
They blitz Terry Rozier. Somehow he finds Cody Martin in the corner, who hits the three. After the timeout, Hornets have the basketball. Terry Rozier fakes one way, goes the other, and knocks it down.
Ooh.
That is a professional shot.
You remember this one?
And a game winner for Malik.
Oh.
Pretty cool. After the timeout, Terry Rozier spins it up and in with contact. Terry on top of Len.
I mean, Fox did everything he could do. That's where you gotta lock in, stay disciplined, and focus.
PJ, little floater. Again, two more for PJ Washington. Monk dribbled it off his foot. Terry's got it. Clean air. And the Hornets have made it a 1 point game.
It's big time.
He didn't make it. That's where the cookie crumbles for the fans here. De'Aaron Fox.
Oh, getting frisky.
Oh, my goodness. That's probably tapped in by Nick Richards. Closest man, Sabonis. They'll give him the two. Talk about a bonus for Sabonis. He gets two without even shooting the ball. Terry Rozier never used his right hand. How do you do?
Not to be denied is Rozier when the game's on the line. Man, what a tough shot.
In the corner, Duarte. Run off the line, goes chest to chest with Terry. Twice! And a delayed whistle. And the call that the Kings wanted is made. That is now five.
Said it never touched the right.
Well, they said it was the fifth team foul. It is not. So the Hornets get the ball back, no damage done, down four. Bridges working on his buddy Malik Monk. Hey. Sabonis rolls. Pass knocked away. Turnover. Hornets ball.
He has Chris Duarte in a mess right now. He doesn't know which way Terry's going, and he's shooting trick shots.
The overplay by Richards knocks that out of bounds.
Terry's gassed. It's all guts right now.
29 points. A day after he physically was unable to even join the team in the arena in Denver.
And leads all scorers with 29.
He's got a 9-point fourth quarter. De'Aaron Fox, a two. Terry looks over Steve Clifford, barking out a play. Final 2 minutes. Terry, shot clock's down to one. Terry Rozier, have a night! With gravel in his guts and spit in his eye! It's a 1-point game!
He's just playing with a game. Wait to see the shot clock run down before he puts it through. Look at this, man.
All right, they're scoring in multiples of two. We're scoring in multiples of three.
You don't like this. You do not like NBA basketball.
In Sacramento. Terry's got the last seven for the Hornets. Draws a crowd. His arm was hit. His arm was hit.
Accosted.
And the Hornets are in the bonus. So Terry Rozier will shoot two free throws once he finally catches. So the Hornets are in the bonus. And Terry will amble over to the free throw line.
He's going to need 2 days off. In the fourth quarter.
Doing it and doing it and doing it well. Both sides of the bonus. Gonna have to slow down Fox at some point. Monk.
Grab it.
Last touch by Sacramento. Hornets ball. Chance to take the lead.
Who do you think this play's going through?
Points in the fourth quarter for the man with the ball. Backdoor cut. PJ! And the Hornets lead!
Use Terry as a decoy. All the gravity towards number three. PJ Reed.
He dribbled off his foot. Hornets have the ball. Cody Martin! Yes! Hundredly D! It's happening again in Sacramento! Some things are meant to be, Del Curry.
Telling you what. What about this Hornet cake? And Nick Richards has got to be the foundation.
Any foul will put a king at the line. Harrison Barnes back into the game. He's been sitting for a while, folks. Keegan Murray, Malik Monk, De'Aaron Fox, Domantas Sabonis, who's played a long time with five fouls. Fox has Martin on him. Tough chance. Rebounded Bridges! And a foul in the backcourt will come the other way and shoot important free throws.
Cody Martin fighting over the screen. Nick Richards didn't have to apply that much help because of the good play by Martin. It allowed him to see the ball but stay with Sabonis, and it forced Fox to a tough shot.
Look at Cody. Fight over the screen. Continue to come. Nick giving ground, but making sure he gets back to Sabonis for the box out. Bridges with a rebound.
All right, time to get greedy mouth, Bridges.
Sometimes greed is a good thing.
Like a gentleman. Both sides with one timeout remaining. Two beauties! And the lead swells. 5-point stiff arm. Fox never got there. Nick Richards gets it to Bridges. And they foul him in the backcourt. Good golly, Miss Molly. Dell, it's another miracle after midnight.
Oh, my goodness. You can't script this any better. He's stunned. He is stunned right now.
They are filing out of here en masse. A sellout crowd of 17,983 have watched the Kings fall apart like a $3 suitcase. They always seem to do that when the Hornets are in town.
I'm telling you what, this team comes in on a back-to-back, two-hour flight from Denver. They got off the ground late, get to the hotel late. You got to prepare quickly. You get Terry Rozier, a fresh Terry Rozier back. Anything's possible.
7-point lead. Fox just lost it out of bounds. Hornets ball, and this one is over. The Hornets will inbound. Mike Brown has called off the dogs. It is Miracle After Midnight, part three. Wow. It's all over. That hideous 11-game losing streak is a memory, a distant one. We are smiling all the way to Chicago. The Hornets pick up a
in the lane and putting it up and in. Nice finish, Steph Curry. That's Pajemski's family attire. Steph Curry, he got the runner and then the fadeaway. Look at Steph. Steph in the corner through two defenders. Found Pajemski. What a find. What a pass by Steph Curry. He is a magician with the ball. Chris Paul and Sharks, a little two-man game. Steph, home free, to lay it up and in. That was as easy as it gets for Steph. Again, Curry's got the 6'10 Wagner on him. Try to yank him back, now drive, now flip it up and in! Steph Curry getting it done! Pajemski curls around Trace, wanted to return the pass to him. Credit the Magic defense, Steph crossover, and rimmed it home. You miss 22 shots and you grab half of them? That's crazy. Steph! He starts to get hot. Forget about it. Shot clock off. Final 5 seconds of the half. Curry crossover three. Good! And a foul! Look at that. Oh my goodness. Splitting two defenders. Cycle it to Curry. Good look for three. There it is. You're good with that offense. Paolo Banchero, Franz Wagner. They both average over 20. In, out, up. Curry in. How about that? The best step back in the league.
The big bucket right there.
He can get that shot up over anybody. Inside 5 minutes, protecting a 2-point lead. Curry flips the defense. Step to the lane. The lane in. Backs up and hits a three. Come on!
That turnover sequence really took the life out of things here. Warriors got to regroup.
Still back to one. Nice. Steph and Clay together.
There's a little bit of a breakdown there. The two defenders kind of stack their separation back to 9 points. Look at the two defenders kind of getting juked out by.
12 second half points for Klay Thompson. So critical. And Carroll missing there. And Kuminga has a chance to high rise. And he knows. Shot clock at 7. Steph trying to put him to sleep. Lay it up and in! A little shimmy shake will do you.
Dallas was bad against Utah defensively.
Driving scoring, but Dallas very good offensively to start this game tonight. Monte Kamara poked the ball away from Luka, who alertly tapped it away from Kamara before stealing it. Now Luka's in a low clock situation himself, but that doesn't bother him. Mavs have been good at that this year. Third fewest fouls per game, just over 18. Oh, nice finish by Luka. And I hope that the landing was A-OK there. You know he's been dealing with that sore left quad as of late.
Brogdon defending Luka the same way.
With a second to spare, Mavericks hit it over the timeline. And Hardaway on the cut.
That's beautiful. This is nothing but eye contact between two players.
Ball into Seth Curry. 20-point Mavs advantage, and that is Luka on the receiving end of a pass through traffic on the cut. The shot selection at times tonight for Portland has left something to be desired. Step back, Jack.
Good spacing on that side. Luka makes the backdoor cut and gets himself a layup.
Pass fake, dribble drive to the hoop. Way! The glass. There is Jones slinging it outside. And then Luka sees a gap to drive. And boom shakalooka. 6. Here it is, Harp. Boom shakalooka.
I like it. Kaboom.
Especially for the Mavericks. Another step back made by Luka. Kyrie advances it up ahead to Luka.
Let's go!
And Luka fouled. Oh, and they'll count it for 31 on a three-point attempt the old-fashioned way. On December the 16th.
To pay attention to detail in this second half, specifically in the third quarter.
Got a clock situation here, but it's a game of beat the clock. You have to be good because it gets late early. Leslie, you have more on Kyrie Irving, by the way, right?
I don't even know how to follow that.
That's Yogi Berra said that. It gets late early.
Okay, can we just talk about how this is his second game back?
Well, perhaps the final 47 seconds we'll see of Luka here in tonight's game as he drives hard to the basket. Yes, stick around. We only got 36 of these 48 minutes. We got time for 12 more minutes of funny stuff tonight. Here's Luka. There's some funny stuff.
Paul George right into the body of Metu, not allowing him any space to get up that bailout three-point shot at the end of the clock.
George eases into the three and knocks it down. Clippers out in front 8-4 against the Suns.
Well, speaking of which, Paul George into Kawhi. The double team is going to come. Paul is able to walk right into
Booker now 2-for-2.
Yeah, 4-for-16 in the last game, and that sometimes is a sign of an omen. Speaking of which, Paul George, aggressive early, because three have been the second one. Now you come off a screen, Metu tries to cheat the screen.
Harden picked up by Grayson Allen. Into George, down the lane, high off the window, counted on a foul. And Paul George may only score in triplicate tonight. 2-and-6, here's Leonard. Back to George for three. It's good again. Paul George with a dozen. That's his third three. George the other way. He's got a few threes already. Crossing blades with Booker. Pull up from the foul line. Oh, it goes for Paul George. He's a perfect 5-for-5. Gets around Booker. Finds George on the wing. Free for three. Tice tries to keep it alive, taps it back to George, attacks the rack, counted on a foul. George with 16 first quarter points.
And then ultimately the steal, Daniel Tice keeping the ball alive.
On Friday against the Pelicans, Metu loses the ball. It's Tice who leads the show. Maybe got away with a carry, finds Leonard on the wing for three. Bucket for Kawhi Leonard. It's his first points, and they're big. It puts the Clippers out in front.
To the mid-range. You think about mid-range between Bill, you know, Booker, and Durant, and Kawhi Leonard.
Clippers by 12. Leonard on Allen. Fades and fires and fills it up.
Kawhi Leonard with all 8 of his points in the second quarter. Clippers by 14.
Well, be happy for your teammates. You know what I mean? That's what it's all about. Celebrate the victories. Be there to support.
Leonard on Allen. Just bullies him right to the rim. And in Kawhi Leonard with a dozen. Timeout, Phoenix.
And shoot 37% from behind the arc this year.
It's been kind of a missing color in his rainbow in terms of consistency. Kawhi Leonard says, I see your three, and I will match it.
Suddenly, mentally, may be a little bit weary and won't be able to finish as strong.
George on the wing for three, picks up where he left off. That's 4 for Paul George from distance.
Yeah, he was on a heater for real, and you got to keep in mind he wasn't regulated to playing point guard either at that particular time. So his freedom, like that of Kawhi Leonard, was to score the ball.
It was lights out. It was curtains for the Clippers. You have to give these things time, and James Harden has been nothing short of phenomenal. Speaking of phenomenal,
it hasn't been sloppy. It's putting Kawhi in the middle of the right there, the free throw line. No help can really come.
Just his 12th main three of the season. 2:45 to play in the third. Clippers by 17. George for three. Can he retaliate? Yes, sir. 5 threes for Paul George. Number 21 for the Clippers. If they can hold on, Phoenix is going to try to make life very uncomfortable for them over the next 10 minutes and 26 seconds. Kawhi Leonard knocks down the jumper. He's got 24.
Lead to an advantage for the Suns.
Leonard singly covered by Allen, goes down the lane, charges to the rim, and a big bucket for Kawhi Leonard. He's got 30.
The hip, got the hip. Markkanen will inbound. JC surveys, Fontecchio, flip to the wrist. And the Pura three-pointer applauded by Dunn. And Utah back within 2. Under 4 to play in Salt Lake. The 3-win Pistons against the 15-win Jazz. Cunningham lost the handle. Gathers it into Bogdanovich. Shot clock runs down to 5. Bogey. Jumper good. Detroit goes season high in points in Salt Lake. 130. They had 66 at the half. Make that 68.
It's not enough for the Jazz to get buckets. They got to get stops and buckets.
Bogdanovich with 31. JC drives. He'll be at the line.
He needs.
Now he's healthy. Missed the 19 games with a calf strain. And he's flowing really free, even more so than what we saw in Detroit. Is that the east side?
Yes.
Yeah. East side. Yeah. Yeah. That's where he's at.
Yep.
JC, after the timeout, drops his 26th point. Jazz down 2. You look at that line on JC. 19 points in the second half. AB goes to work. Trailed by Sexton. Jumps it, scores it. And 23 for the man we called Houdini.
Yeah. Another guy who's got a home right next to Boyan.
Missed shot by Sexton. Jazz needs stops as we're under 3 to play. Oh, yes, crunch time has arrived. Detroit holding on to a 4-point lead. They have their last road win, October 27th at Charlotte.
Big mess there.
You know, October's a lifetime ago. And here we are in the first week of January of 2024. JC shows the ball, jumps it, scores it. Wow, Clarkson goes for 28. And can the Jazz get over the hill? Down 2. Just over 2 minutes to play.
Pistons are going to take their time and find a weakness in the Jazz's zone. Usually the middle.
Sexton slips and falls. Wide open shot. Missed by Burks. Markkanen rebounds it on the backside. Clarkson the hot hand at the moment. Markkanen lowers his shoulder, drives, lost the ball. Bogdanovich, right place, right time, strolls around the floor to burn clock. Another stop. Another stop in desperate need for the Jazz. Bogey drives in on Kessler. Stops, leans back. That ball takes a bounce out. Chased down by Simone.
OKC. Dribble drive into the paint. Now rolls back out.
Oh, he's got a mismatch out here.
Thought about the three. Fontecchio. He'll drive in the paint. Drop it. Reverse it. Walker loves that shot. He'll put it behind his head. And Utah tied with Detroit at 132.
I wonder what happened to Durham in that paint. Yes, he was probably trying to draw a foul. And Walker Kessler just wide open.
Bogey ball kicked out.
Anything.
Jazz are in the bonus with a foul to give and two timeouts.
Bogey slips inside. It's off the rim. Rebound inside. Sexton trying to dig that ball away. He's got it. Timeout, Utah.
You don't want to rush it for a two-for-one. But if you can get a good look.
Collins surveys the floor. Simone in one corner. Markkanen in the other. Now Lowry breaks down the baseline off to Clarkson. Shot clock five. Leans in for three. Got it! Oh, the flame is on!
Wow! Maybe a bogey coming off the screen.
Cunningham will inbound. Bogey denied by Fontecchio. Right at midcourt. Now they switch Markkanen. Bogdanovic. He goes to his left hand. Drives it home off the glass. Wooden drop. And that ball will come off the hand of Kessler. 22 seconds to play. Shot clock will jump back to 14.
See the rebound there. Yep. And it ends up rolling off of Kessler's fingers. It's close. But it does roll off of Walker's fingers.
Burks needs help. Got down to about a four count. Livers, ball knocked away by Walker, picked up by Bogey. Deep! Got it! Got it! Bogdanovic! Here we go. Buckle up on this Wednesday night in Salt Lake City. JC behind the three-point line. Markkanen screams out. Triples up! Got it! Markkanen tries to finish off Detroit!
No timeouts here.
AB going coast to coast. He'll throw up a prayer. Got it!
Wow.
What a game. Clutch buckets throughout the night.
Force a double team there and leave their shooters wide open.
Oh, nice look down low to Paolo. He lost it. Gets his own rebound and puts it back in. Herder, they need somebody to be consistent. Shot clock down to four. Magic got to hurry. Paolo pulls from three. Splash.
That was a nice shot. Paolo looking down, setting his feet.
Watch Paolo take this quick look, see where he's at, and then straight up. You know, that's the way Mike Brown wants them to play. He doesn't want to play against a set Magic defense with their size.
Shot clock is at four. Paolo, he's got another three. Back-to-back threes for Bancaro.
The lead pass from Monk off the bounce.
They're really good at transition. Paolo, pull up. Two more for Paolo. Needs to be a big Bancaro night, and it's headed that way.
Bumping medium a little bit higher. Again, a little disjointed with a lineup that hasn't spent a lot of time together.
Bancaro! He's 9 for 12. He's got 18 points. Magic just not getting enough stops. They can't stop that man. Magic have been outstanding here in the third quarter.
Nice.
Wendell, good look for three. Got it. Two threes tonight for Dell.
That's his first made three. Jalen Suggs with a pull-up jumper.
Paolo straight away. Got it. Three more for Bancaro. His fourth three tonight, and the Magic go back in the lead. Magic down one. Bancaro goes to work. Pull-up jumper. Got it. Have a night, Paolo. Bancaro drives on Sabonis. Gets right to the rack and lays it in. We got a one-point game. Bancaro. Defended by Barnes. Pull-up jumper. Got it! Three-pointer! Big-time Bancaro!
Kumbaya!
Drives baseline, swatted by Bataze, the Georgian giant. Met him at the rim. Now Chuma, all the way to the glass, out to Bancaro, three, Bancaro buckets!
Chuma taking it the length of the court. Look, he's got all the defense right there around him. Paolo wide open.
down by one. Bancaro over Lyles. Got it! Two more for Bancaro. Give him 37 on the night. What's it going to be? Inbound to Bancaro, right at the rim. Yes! He lays it in! Bancaro ties the game! How did he get open? How did he finish?
How about this by Paolo? Boy, I tell you what, how did the Kings come away with that without fouling?
Without
that
fouling
him. Streak. Look at him step in front of Toscano Anderson and just bully his way to the bucket. 41 tonight for Paolo Bancaro.
Get it into Bancaro. Five on the shot clock. Jalen Suggs, three. Big if it goes. Oh! Got it! Three for Suggs. That's a franchise record.
Gets caught up, finds Chris Duarte. Duarte had 12 points last night. First shot, no, but Domas there for the putback count.
And that was just an area that the Kings. His offensive rebounds, he was an absolute beast last night. Had 8 offensive rebounds.
Domas decides to kick it out. HB left open. Cash money for Harrison Barnes.
Oh, that looks sweet.
Yeah.
You can't do anymore.
Their largest lead of the game right now. As Malik trying to do some get back, finding JaVale. Takes the contact, one at the end, one. He'll take the bucket.
He's got 3 field goals and 2 of them are
deep. Uh-oh! No Franz Wagner the rest of the way. Barnes catches shoot. Tag. You get a 3. You get a 3. Off the steal. Off night. Back to Malik. Malik. Transition, yes sir. Sacramento off and running. They got 13 fast break points now. Queen trying to get in his bag. Tough runner, nope. Here comes Malik, 15 points all here in the second as he finds Domas. Oh, running the break, the big fella with the hammer. Keegan forces a tough high arcer. Well played. Domas the rip and run in transition. Going up high. Keegan coming down hard. Kings offense a little stagnant here. Let's see if they can get some movement as they go to the big foul. Domas counted and the foul. A big bucket from Domantas Sabonis. Kings offense a little stagnant here. Let's see if they can get some movement as they go to the big foul. Domas counted and the foul. A big bucket from Domantas Sabonis.
It's going to rip his arms up. We see it all the time. Steph Curry, James Harden. I mean, the list goes on and on.
Monk looking for JaVale. Contact counted and the foul. JaVale McGee off the bench. Oh, Monk dancing with it. Malik in his bag. Got it. Orlando up 103-96. Their largest lead of the game. Counted. Malik as he gives him the nasty.
Broadcasting partners from Orlando are laughing right now. They are in awe.
They think they're at Disney World right now. I mean, oh, they're going to wave that off. Malik is saying, count it.
Make sure you're getting the matchup that you want. You don't want to find yourself in a position down the stretch where it's an advantage for them. But Domas, talk about taking advantage, going all the way to the glass right there. Make sure you're getting the matchup that you want. You don't want to find yourself in a position down the stretch where it's an advantage for them. But Domas, talk about taking advantage, going all the way to the glass right there.
Here's Harrison Barnes into Malik Monk's hands. Sabonis with the high screen. Monk turning downhill, going to the left hand. We're knotted up at 118. Malik Monk now with 31, a season high, as Jamal Mosley is going to take a timeout. Monk. Guarded by Queen, using that Domas screen. Malik the scoop, count it! Money Malik Monk puts Sacramento on top by 1.
I mean, about 2 minutes a game at this point in the season.
Here comes Monk, guarded by Bataze. Domas with the strong screen. Oh, the big fella! Sending in the hammer and the flex.
Number 2 is Brooke. Antetokounmpo with a beautiful diving reverse for 2.
He had minutes of restriction early on coming back from that knee injury. But the last 2 months, absolutely balling.
A spinner by Wembanyama. That was with the offhand, and he goes right into Lopez.
I mean, David Robinson, the overall number one pick in my draft in 1987, the Admiral.
Antetokounmpo over Sochan. Twisting an ankle the other night.
65 starts a year ago, right?
In 68 games played. Amazing, yeah, where he is now. Antetokounmpo sneaks it in again right around the rim, falls.
As soon as he gets the basketball, just splits the double team. And if you're going to foul someone, Giannis, he can't get that ball above his shoulders. And that just shows you the strength.
After the 24-10 for the Milwaukee Bucks, and on the road, 8-7. Antetokounmpo drives into Sochan.
Late rotation.
Fake a spin and a step inside. Giannis, 11 right there with the pirouette to find the two.
And look at them guard one another.
Trying to poke it away.
Oh, right back, right? Didn't I say there was going to be plays?
Yep. Here's the move by Giannis and the finish.
And it was beautiful.
And then right afterwards, just throw it off the glass. The Bucks went for the steal, didn't get it. Look at this. He knew he couldn't do a little finger roll, so just throw it off the rim. They've got to be scrappy defensively.
Portis got it from Giannis. Knocked away by Wembanyama. Knocked away, another turnover. They got five, the Bucks do. Wesley drives, rejected by Antetokounmpo. Portis at the other end. San Antonio shooting 52%. Same for the Bucks. Austin, pickpocketed by Lillard. Two on one with Giannis. Sochan, he's free from three. Oh, Wembanyama climbing the ladder. Two-point game with Antetokounmpo right there. The first time these two teams met, Wemby didn't play. Nice drive right there by Giannis Antetokounmpo. Champagne down the baseline, rejected by Lopez. One of the top shot blockers in the NBA. Antetokounmpo galloping, soars for two. Timeout taken.
And had a healthy Middleton not played tonight, the Bucks would have been subject to disciplinary action since Middleton was an all-star back in 2022.
Wembanyama just put in his 10th, 12 for Middleton. Wembanyama, oh, goes back!
Oh, no!
And puts it down!
Are you kidding me? Come on, unicorn, stop it, stop this! Look at this, this is around a guard in Lillard. And a finish over a seven-footer.
Oh, man. Special talent. A special talent.
Wembanyama.
Look at this.
Whoa!
Man. A talent like this at his size. I mean, he doesn't even bring the ball to his right hand. By Lillard. He can get going now that Middleton is lost for the evening as Wembanyama starting to heat up here.
Lillard out of the combo.
Oh,
he went in there, and that was with determination.
Giannis is saying is, look, young fella, anything you can do, I can do way better. Look at this, splits the double team, and how about the finish with the left hand for the Greek Freak.
22 for Antetokounmpo. Here we go with the Bucks. Lillard finding Giannis Antetokounmpo inside, and he knifes his way for the jam and puts the Bucks up by four. It's Jones to Sochan with Portis defending. Inside, Wembanyama got it.
And how about the back cut on Giannis?
He gets it out to Lillard. He's got 12, kicks it out. Giannis will drive a full head of steam, barging for two. Timeout taken the hard way. The double-double again. 26th of the season for him. The Bucks on top by five on TNT. Lillard. 2.5 to play in the third. Giannis inside, corkscrews his way into the defense of Manu Kanellishvili. He's been a starter, but accepting the role off the bench, which Greg Popovich says makes us better. Antetokounmpo, got it. Nice shot outside. First three tonight. Wembanyama will take it in on Lopez. And Victor Wembanyama's got 23. We've got Antetokounmpo, and all the cross court to Lopez. Open in the corner. Oh, that's a nice block. Wembanyama deflection, a block by him, his 30.
This decision to limit Wembanyama's play to 24 minutes per game and not allowing him to play both ends of back-to-back. Now there is
30 points, 13 rebounds, and 7 assists. Lopez outside. Giannis twirls and gets it to drop. And the Spurs lead by one. Keldon Johnson goes into Connaughton. 50% shoot for the Spurs with a nice fake, but now he's doubled down low and kicks it out in the corner. Jones drives over Connaughton, got it. It's a three-point lead for the Spurs.
Got to come back with Victor at some point. You got a three-point lead.
Here he comes. He's getting off the bench, just as you said that. We're clairvoyant.
Winnable game here.
Lillard's had a big fourth quarter. Keldon Johnson will be the defender. It's Connaughton against Ausman. Shot clock at three and across the lane. The ball knocked away. And it is off the Bucks.
Great job there by Jetty Osman. And fantastic minutes as Victor Wembanyama back on the floor here to close this ball game up with the Spurs up three. And just a shade under four left.
Osman is out. Popovich has made the move. 23 points and 8 rebounds for Wembanyama. And here comes Keldon Johnson. Lopez again. We'll watch Wembanyama. This is Vassell. Move and he'll follow with a jam. And he's just given San Antonio their biggest lead tonight of 5.
Again, we can't tell you enough, this Milwaukee team has struggled on the road. And Giannis.
And a free throw to try to complete the three-point play and go for 35. Two-point game, 3.5 to go.
What a big bucket and free throw there by Giannis. Here's the zone for Milwaukee.
The Gumbo with a good feed and a shove inside. It was on Lopez.
And Victor through the free throw line here.
Wembanyama is 4 of 4 from the stripe.
I can't say that, you know, he's perfect from the free throw line. You got to,
well, what's worse?
You actually saying to the basketball gods the 4 for 4.
I'm just reporting what's going on. I'm a simple-minded broadcaster. Here comes Antetokounmpo, and Wembanyama is in the way, and they clear it out. Now he'll step back and take a three. Giannis drains it. 38 for Antetokounmpo with a beautiful train.
But again, you'll live with that.
Here's Vassell. Big night for him. 34 points. Wembanyama, he'll take a three. Rebound. Victor inside the crash. And the foul.
That's an offensive foul.
It goes on Wembanyama. He's got 5.
Nice job there.
It sure was.
Giannis.
It was.
Taking that charge.
Lillard will take it and sifting through traffic. Wide open three out of the Kumbo. Oh, that was a killer. 9-1 Milwaukee run is the... And a trip to NBA All-Star 2024. Vote daily on the NBA app or at NBA.com/vote. 9-1 run by the Bucks. 2 threes by Giannis coming in this fourth. Sohan a shot, no. Rebound inside, claimed by Lillard. 2 minutes to play. Lillard and Giannis Antetokounmpo, Reggie, had the last 22 Milwaukee Buck points.
We're at 66 points right now between the two.
Keldon Johnson is watching out of the Kumbo and outside. Connaughton three in and out. Keldon Johnson the rebound.
This is the time when Devin Vassell has to make a play for this team.
Johnson will drive. Beasley will defend. Basket no. Rebound Connaughton. Couple misses right there by the Spurs.
This kind of shows you the youth and the inexperience and not having a true closer on this team.
Lillard drives into Sohan. Rem Banyama wipes it away with a rejection. It's Jones racing the other way. Vassell. Rem Banyama three. Good! We are tied!
Wimby is doing it at both ends of the floor. Four block shots and two made threes.
27 for Wembanyama. Adetokounmpo outside, under a minute to go. Giannis drives, drops the sledgehammer. Woo, wow, 43.
What a game. And hit back-to-back here in the closing moments of this fourth.
Nice stroke, three-point play, three-point Bucks lead.
And you don't need a three here if you're San Antonio. Get a good quality look, and then you're going to have to trust your defense.
Adetokounmpo's got 14 here in the fourth. Jones drives and kicks. Sohan, triple. Rebound, Giannis Antetokounmpo, 14.
That was a great look.
Lillard the other way, half minute to go.
They have to send help. There's no way that Jones is going to be able to guard him.
The screen, the drive. Oh, it's knocked away by Wembanyama. Knocked away by Wembanyama. Timeout, San Antonio.
And extended minutes for Victor, right? Up to 26.
Wembanyama has five blocks. Adetokounmpo has three.
Oh, this is what I would do is, if you can get a quality three, sure, you go for it. But if you can get a quick two, you assume that the Bucks are going to call a timeout to get Giannis out the game.
Trey Jones has it. Lillard defends. It's Vassell. Down to seven. Off to Wembanyama to tie. Jones, no! Rebound off of San Antonio and 1.8 there, and Trey Jones had a chance to tie it with that three. Bucks are on top by three, and Connaughton keeps it there with the miss. Connaughton, a 73% free throw shooter, 0-1 at the line, got that big one to make it a 4-point game, and we got an illegal inbound by San Antonio.
By Victor.
And Milwaukee has the ball. It's a violation on
San Antonio.
On the Spurs. And that'll do it. And Giannis and Lillard scored 25 consecutive Bucks points to secure the win. And they've scored 25 of the last 26.
They have dropped the first two meetings. They have another game coming up third week of February as Jokic working on Looney. Little hook shot is good. Jokic adding to his total now. He's got 27. Yeah, look at that. 60 second half points already. We got 6:20 left in this fourth quarter.
They haven't been able to take anything away tonight. 15 made threes, but 54 points in the paint. The Warriors are last in the league, averaging only 43 in the paint, 54 tonight.
Thompson always left open, and he missed it. Looney with the offensive board, got another one. Another chance here for Golden State. Shot clock to seven. Curry, no. And Michael Porter Jr. with a rebound. Curry started 2 for 7, just got cooking after that. Made 4 3-pointers, 9 for his last 12. Murray to Jokic, inside, in the paint.
Gordon the offensive board. And Gordon.
Consistency.
Been to the line five times in this one as Gordon hits both free throws.
Well, Jokic only averages shooting just short of six free throw attempts a game, so he doesn't get to the line a lot.
Curry almost lost the handle, keeps it going. Jokic trying to stay with him, and Curry missed it at a loose ball foul. Golden State pushed their lead to 18. At one point, Nuggets' biggest lead tonight was 10 points. Here's Gordon in the corner, and here come the Nuggets. Corner three from Aaron Gordon. They've been daring him to shoot those threes. Gordon's got 22 now in his second game back after missing two. And Michael Malone is upset. Steve Kerr wants a timeout.
So it's tough as a referee when on the same call both coaches are upset with you.
Yeah, pretty sure Jokic is not going to stop because Steve Kerr is requesting it. Pajemski probing now with two on him, the two stars. Now Wiggins, five to shoot, gives it back. Pajemski, the lefty. And Gordon just denies him. Shot clock violation.
Late.
Denver's on a 7-0 run here in the last minute and a half. They were trailing by 18. Jokic kicks it. Three-pointer flies. Gordon short. Gordon with the putback. Impressive.
Well, Gordon's been very, very good tonight, but both offenses have been very good. Other than the three-point shooting, Denver's been very good offensively. It's been tough to come by stops tonight.
Gordon's got nine in the quarter. 24 for the game. That's the 10th offensive rebound for Denver. Curry, bullet pass out to Wiggins. In and out it goes. Murray with the rebound. Nuggets trying to keep this run going here. 9-0 currently. Murray for three. Short. Long offensive board to Jokic. Gordon's got Curry posted up. And that is a foul on Curry. Free throws for Gordon. Sean Wright asking JT Orr who he had.
Finding him and he takes advantage down there. This is always a little bit of a problem. Gordon, not a great free throw shooter.
Well, Gordon tonight.
Steve Kerr wanting to get a little bit more size on Aaron Gordon, who's taking advantage of them around the basket. So he goes with two bigs now. Something that he doesn't do a lot, doesn't like to do, particularly when he hasn't had Draymond Green. But right now, situation calls for it.
7-point game. Gordon's got 11 in the quarter. 26 for the game. Pajemski running the point here. Gets Curry off the ball for the moment. Caldwell Pope on Curry. Tough man to shake. Curry with a little hook. No good. And Looney going to be hit with a loose ball foul. The push. And Looney picking up a couple of fouls here in the last few possessions. Fifth team foul.
Sees the two hands in the back. Jokic did a great job selling the call because he was too far under the rim.
Nikola Jokic at the line here with a chance to cut it to five, and he does so.
Which makes it another clutch game by the definition of those stats.
13-0 run. Curry, he's fouled, and Curry will go to the line. After the promo period, add it for $9.99 to a max base plan. As Curry 2-for-2 from the line. Curry certainly having an MVP caliber season with a strong finish to the year. He's ninth in scoring. He's having a great year. He's got 30 tonight.
Well, he's been in a little bit of a slump, but played very well against Orlando and has had it going tonight.
Jokic gives it to Gordon. Gordon pulls his way in and a foul on Jackson Davis. A very strange, serious injury. Hand. This is his second game back.
Yeah, that's scary. And I'm a dog person. I've got three dogs at home and love animals, but that's scary.
5-point game. Gordon with 13 in the quarter after the free throws. It's a 15-2 run. Chris Paul working with Thompson. Curry, Sharitz, and Jackson Davis on the floor. Four to shoot here. Caldwell Pope disrupting. Here is Curry, late clock, three-pointer. No good. Jokic with the rebound. Jokic with 29, 9, and 9. Denver cannot convert.
Got a good look at a three in the corner from a 40% three-point shooter that couldn't knock it down.
Interesting five on the floor here for Steve Kerr. Gordon's on Curry. A great defender. Jackson Davis goes strong with the left hand.
That tells you the confidence they have in this rookie to have him on the floor at the end of close games.
Four-year player at IU in Indiana. Here is Watson. Sticks it. Big shot for Peyton Watson. Had a thunder dunk earlier. Now he cans a three. It's a four-point game. Two-possession lead for Golden State. Now Jokic ends up on Curry. Here's Thompson. The blow by. The runner. No good. Sharitz offensive rebound. Shovels it out to Paul. Reset. KCP on Curry. Now Gordon. Curry trying to get by him. Curry, a three-pointer. Missed it badly. Gordon was all over him. Paul put it up. Too late. Won't count. Shot clock violation. Spectacular defensive stand by the Nuggets. To the Nuggets puzzle in their championship year last year.
Yeah, no question. Very versatile defender. Can guard bigger, stronger guys down low. And can guard guards out on the perimeter.
Jokic from Murray. Oh, he leaves it for Gordon. The lob from Jokic. His 10th assist of the game.
For the Nuggets this year, and a huge possession right here for both teams.
15 in the corner for Gordon. That's a 20-4 Denver run. Gordon's got 30. Chris Paul at the controls.
Guarded by Jokic.
Wiggins back on the floor for Golden State. Got the Splash Brothers with Paul, who's going to fire the three. Missed it. Sharitz offensive board, lost the handle. Watson's got it.
Very interesting. They gave Chris Paul the three there. Put Jokic on him and backed up.
Denver can tie or take the lead. Gordon riding a season high right now. Watson in the corner. Good save. Six to shoot. Jokic now. Sharitz on him. Jokic drops the shoulder and ties this game at 127. The Nuggets have covered an 18-point deficit. 2 seconds separating shot and game clock. Caldwell Pope on Curry. Now Jokic. And Murray with the steal. There's a clock issue there.
No, timeout. No,
oh, I beg your pardon. So 3.6 left.
Getting it on the run going up the floor.
Jokic has it. Clock ticks. Got to put one up. Jokic for the win. Oh, it's good. Jokic got it off in time. And the Nuggets win it.
Now 24th made threes in his last 11 games for Jalen Suggs. Got it sighted in a little bit from distance.
Absolutely.
Leads the team in threes made. Paolo pull-up jumper. Game on Wednesday. Two away from his career high. Magic force a turnover. Here comes Banchero. Drives on Jokic. Plays it in. Jokic already has a foul. Yes. Smart by Paolo.
Yes. A lot of respect for this Orlando Magic half-court defense.
Well, and that was the big talking point, wasn't it? As yep. Paolo pulls up, he's got another one. What a start for Banchero.
Not letting this young Magic team that's down bodies feel like they got a chance. Long way to go.
Great take by Banchero. Terrific move. Two more, and he'll have a chance for a three-point play.
Yeah, this is pretty good. No chance for Murray out on the perimeter to stay one-on-one with Paolo.
He has been motivated against his former team. Hey! Paolo drives on Jokic. Shot no good. Here's Suggs. Three. Got it. Racing the other way.
Nuggets pass was too much for Watson. He saves it, but it comes back to Orlando. Banchero right to the rack and dunks it down to Banchero.
Banchero, quick spin all the way to the rim.
Great D by Wagner, holding his ground.
You just got to hold your ground and make him stay down on all the shot fakes. Just make him take a contested shot.
Wagner for three. Got it. Two-point game now. Nice contest there. Porter Jr. can't finish. Banchero. That's a beauty. Turnaround jumper, automatic for Banchero. Call it a two, though. 16 now in the game for Porter. Nice pass to Mo Wagner, who spins it in somehow.
For the most part, you can see why they are going to those three guys, Gordon, Porter Jr., and Jokic.
Oh, they're contributing.
Nice. Porter. Here we go.
And Carroll in the lane, off the window and in.
There you go. You know, there were a lot of people that didn't think that the Rudy Gobert trade was a good one, that it would work. And after they've gotten acclimated to it, he and Karl Anthony Towns making it work. Speaking of making it work, nice out-of-bounds play there after the timeout.
Chuma going to try. Got it. Back-to-back threes.
Magic. You got to get out and defend the three-point line. Chuma Okeke.
Jalen's tied his career high again with six made threes. We got a long way to go. Banchero to a streaking Wagner who lays it in.
The best, not bad. And then how about Paolo finding Mo Wagner on the cut?
Nearly had a steal.
Cole Anthony knocking down a long ball. Get Paolo another assist, Dante. Good job looking up the floor.
He'll race the other way. Defended by Cole and he lost the handle. Paolo with the steal. Wagner drives, lays it in. Mo Wagner with 19. Banchero already with a triple-double, 20 points. Three. Got it. Three more for Banchero. His first three tonight.
You got even. It's kind of what Jalen does, right?
It's a great point.
And then he just goes right by you.
That's our Jim Brown.
Yeah.
Jamal Murray trying to get loose. Backs down Cole Anthony. Turn around in the lane. Oh, it hit every part of the rim and fell in.
Soft touch.
Such a gifted scorer. 18 points now for Murray.
Nuggets now with 60 points in the paint.
Two-point lead for the Magic.
Ooh, overpass. Paolo had the shot, tried to make an extra pass.
Murray pull up three, no good. Fought for by Jokic. Magic get it. Rebound number 11 for Mo Wagner. He's got 19 and 11. Magic with the lead by two, 4.5 to go. Cinch it up tight. Here we go again. Magic trying to knock off the defending champs. Cole, pull up.
Yes.
Got it. Splash, Cole Anthony. 21 now for Cole. Lead is 4. Magic gutting it out.
On one with Jokic.
Trying to back down Wagner. Double team comes and they poke it away. Banchero, head down. Full head of steam. He has it poked away. Aaron Gordon comes up with it. And he's fouled by Suggs. That'll put Aaron Gordon at the free throw line. From the free throw line this year, 68% in his career. First one is up.
On the line!
4 minutes to go. Magic lead by 4. Gordon trying to make it 3. He's got 13 points, 7 rebounds tonight. Free throw is up. In it. 3-point lead for the Magic. Who's going to get Coach Mosley a bucket?
Like number 5-0 or number 5. A couple of bucket getters there.
Well, you got one of them right now.
Yep.
Works on Caldwell Pope, has it knocked out of bounds. Yeah, that's a great job by Mo Wagner. Cole was hot. You got to make sure Cole doesn't pick up a technical.
Yep.
See if there was a read.
It's the reach here.
Yep. Coach Mosley wanted something. I don't know that they'll challenge. He wanted to get a timeout for sure.
After replay review, the ball last touches Anthony and then goes out of bounds. Successful challenge, Denver. It'll be Denver's ball. 24 on the shot clock.
Back in Denver, under 4 minutes to go, Cole Anthony had the ball poked away. It looked like it would stay with Orlando. That was the original call. Challenge Denver, overturned. It goes back to Denver. Tough break. Looked like Caldwell Pope might have reached in, but anyway, Denver gets the ball. Jokic in the lane. Tough shot. Rolls off. Battled for. Suggs has it. Ahead to Queen. He'll settle down and pull it out. Suggs with his career night. Now over to Bancaro. Bancaro with 28. Finds Queen. Drives in the lane. Wagner. Now to Cole. Big three. Oh, that would have been huge. Fought for by Suggs. Big offensive rebound. And it looked like he either stepped out or was pushed. Looks like he was pushed.
Oh, fight.
Banged up, sore. Got to hit free throws. This free throw would give him a career high. Deep breath. Shot is up and in. Makes it a two-possession game with that offensive rebound. Under three to go.
That's what this Magic team does. They win the hustle battles.
Now he's got to guard Murray. Working the screen with Jokic. Gets through it. Murray. Pull up. Jumper. Terrific defense by Suggs. And it's out of bounds on Aaron Gordon.
Let me tell you something, Dante. That not many players can get over the top of that Jokic screen. Murray and Jokic so good in that because Jokic gets such a good piece, Jalen would not have it. He went right over the top of that and stayed with Murray.
Bancaro, pull up three. Rattled out. He had a great look. Somehow that fell out. Suggs nearly had the steal. He poked it away. He read that the whole way.
Oh, he was playing a little free safety right there. Made a nice break on the ball, but just couldn't come up with it.
Paolo's upset. That was a terrific look. He wanted that one. Would have been huge. Got to do it on this end. Here's Jokic. Back and down Wagner. Finds Murray. Back to Jokic. Hook shot in the lane. Rattles out. Fought for by Orlando and Denver. They'll say off Orlando. It'll stay with the Nuggets.
I don't know if he did or not.
Yeah, it looked like he bounced it out of bounds. Jokic makes Orlando pay. Jumper in the lane. We got a whistle here.
Oh, he's working on the clock.
I'm sure the clock is right. Under 2 minutes to go. What an incredible fight out of this Magic team. They've got 17 threes again tonight. They're up by two with the ball. Paolo defended by Gordon. Finds Wagner. Down low to Cole. Up and under. Got it to go. How did he finish? 23 for Cole. Jokic in the lane. The rumbler is good.
They just go so quick. They're not going to get too upset. You've got to score and get back in transition. Jokic getting it up the floor quick.
He's got 29, does Nikola Jokic. He's so impressive. Finishing the lane. Wagner to the corner. Big three. Cole Anthony, too strong. Fought for by Queen. Saved. No. Stepped out of bounds.
And this Magic team is just scrapping. They are everywhere.
One of these threes would have been huge here down the stretch.
Watch the long rebound here. Look at where Queen came from, Dante. He was on the other side of the court, able to get a piece of that one.
Poked it away clean, but stepped out of bounds.
There we go. Plenty of this.
Here's Jokic. Draws the double team. Look down low to Aaron Gordon. Dunks it down.
No foul called. Good job by the Magic. Get it out quick and attack.
Split the defense. We're now coming up on 1 minute left, and we're knotted up at 118 apiece. Magic need a bucket. Who's got one in them? Bancaro, five, floater, no good. Rebound Murray, fought for by the Magic, and we're going to call a foul.
89%.
Thought you were going to get it.
I did too.
8 points. Murray trying to make it six. 88% from the line this year. Shot is up and in. Magic down two. 47 seconds to go. Incredible effort here in Denver.
Vaquero goes to work. Fives on Gordon. Gets to the basket. He was fouled. Shot no good. Nearly had a chance for a three-point play, but he'll go to the line for two big free throws.
The Magic just 18 of 30. They got 19 of 30 at the free throw line in this game.
With 34 seconds to go in Denver. This would be point number 30. Got it. Rattles it home.
Big time.
Denver's going to go. Can Orlando get a stop? Here comes Murray, defended by Suggs. Ten on the shot clock. Knocked off a screen from Jokic. Cross court to Caldwell Pope. Drives it on Queen. Through the legs of Jokic. Mo Wagner has it. He's going to drive. Leave it for Vaquero, who's hammered from behind, and he'll go to the line.
Jokic, now Campalo making pay.
Yes.
Hits the first free throw, and Orlando has taken the lead. Can he give Orlando a two-point lead? And will Denver call a timeout? Free throw is up and in. Timeout, Denver.
Got to.
Wow, what a finish. Do everything you can to not let him get a three. Jokic finds Murray, defended by Wagner. Clock is at four. Murray drives. He's got to get it off quick. Shot. Did he get it off in time? No good. He misses. And the Magic pull off the mile-high miracle.
Before the game, about how they need to set the foundation for how the game is going to be played in that first quarter to offset the bad starts as Marcus Smart hits a three. Snatches it with one hand, pushes it up the floor. Finds Desmond Bane. Back out to Smart. No hesitation there. And Marcus Smart nails another. And he's got 7 points in 4 minutes.
He really did. And he's got to be another guy. If you're going to play him, he's got to score because that's what he does.
Moran, that's what he does. Knocks down the three with five.
Because they don't like him.
David Roddy gets a running start. Kicks it out to Tillman. Smart launching three-pointers. He's already taken five. He's hit three. Tillman to Bane. Inside pass deflected. I think Reddish got a hand on it. Jaren Jackson. Three-pointer is good. That's the fifth three-pointer for Memphis. And they're back with for Davis. 16 for James. Lakers by eight. Desmond Bane back to Smart. Marcus Smart, another three. That's his fourth of the first half.
And another great pass by Desmond. And
poked it away. Bane only has 2 points, but he leads the team in assists. Steps back, three-pointer, got it. His second field goal, and the Grizzlies back with it, too.
That was really well defended by Bane, but a better pass by Reeves.
Smart, another three. Marcus Smart, 5 three-pointers in the first half. He's got 19. Bane way outside, hits the three. Desmond Bane, his second three-pointer, and it's a one-point game. That's so important for Memphis, plus eight. Jackson leads into a three-pointer, and that's good. Jaren Jackson Jr. is shooting 33% from downtown this season. Morant on the drive, kicks it out, Bane. Jackson a three-pointer, that's good. How about Bane, the quick pass? Desmond Bane is not shooting the ball for two.
And yet he's proving everyone wrong.
Last pick of the first round in 2020. Marcus Smart connects again. And Marcus Smart's got 6 three-pointers now.
For sure.
Jaren Jackson up top to Bane. Again, they had a Bane way outside. Hits the three. Desmond Bane from long distance.
And well defended.
Lakers up six. Under four to play third quarter. Jackson looking for that three again. Jaren Jackson, he's 4 for 5 from three-point range. Although a lot of officials will tell you the worst games to officiate are blowouts. This is far from that. Ja Morant rattles in the three. 18 for his career. He's a 32% three-point shooter. Steps behind, sets, fires, connects again. Back-to-back threes. Morant's 3 for 5 from downtown tonight. 11-23 on the season. But they've played much better since he's back. Smart pokes it away from James. Smythe throws it ahead. Zaire Williams, corner three, puts it in. Williams nails it. And the Grizzlies back up by two. Marcus Smart hits a three. Smart with his seventh three-pointer of the night. He's got 25. His career.
And the Lakers are falling on the pick and roll with Reeves and Davis in this game. He's using Reeves and LeBron.
Jaren Jackson a three. Got it. Jaren Jackson with his fifth three-pointer. 5 of 6 from downtown.
A pushing match with Biombo. But a quick mismatch is to Davis's advantage.
Marcus Smart hesitation. Zaire Williams three-pointer is good. Williams off the bench with 13 points. Davis picks up Bain. Bain step back three-pointer, puts it in. Desmond Bain drills the three, and it's a 10-point lead. Road trip. They've been much better on the road this year. Bain looking. Smart long three-pointer. Bang! Marcus Smart from downtown. And that makes it an 11-point game. Games he's played, they'll be 6-3. And looking to make sure they can get in at the very least. The play-in is Bain, just adds the finishing touches. How about Bain tonight?
So Cunningham will get it. He has been the scorer in the fourth, also the assist guy got during that last dunk. And reversing it up and in to tie the game.
They're setting up a ball screen for Durin to go get him. And he just thought to catch the Warriors off guard and go baseline where everybody's worrying about the ball screen that was going to happen.
16-5 Detroit run. Klay Thompson making sure he got to the line. Good pump fake and then lean in. That's what the league has become right now. Just jump into people and shoot free throws.
Yeah. I love what Klay was talking about. The conversation he had with Coach, not worrying about validation coming from others, naysayers, understanding how successful he's been, being grateful and thankful for the career he's had, and just going out and having a good time, enjoying his teammates, enjoying life. But you got to enjoy this night with a win.
And Klay dropping in two key free throws. And now the Warriors try to dig in defensively. And you stop Cunningham. It's a 1-2-2 zone look here. Now they'll switch it. Bogdanović, wing three, got it. 11 down in this fourth quarter, and now the Warriors have work to do.
You're in the bonus if you're the Warriors, so stay aggressive.
Steph turning the corner, and he will get to the line. So Klay free throws, now Steph with two.
That's it, though. We just talked about it. That's the NBA. Throw your body in there. Durin is going, what did I do? And I'll tell him, you did nothing. The Steph initiated, and that's a foul in today's NBA. He initiated the contact, made sure he got it.
Last night against Denver, the free throws were 11-2 favoring the Nuggets in the fourth quarter. The fourth quarter free throws often are the key to winning a game.
That's big. And it really wasn't even because of bad Warrior defense. It was just the Nuggets were taking it to him, and Gordon was amazing. But getting to the free throw line is so important. And
Klay hit two. Steph hit two. 1-point game.
Can you get a stop? You went in the zone last time. Now you're back in a man.
Cunningham. Work on Pajemski. Lose the handle. Ivy picked it up and threw it away. Huge possession here. Minute 10. 1-point lead in the ball. Two men jump at Curry. He'll back up on Bogdanović for three.
What's that handoff stagger?
Bounds the ball. Bogdanović, he wanted that three. Klay ran him off the line and then had it blocked. Great defense, Klay Thompson.
You got to give Klay credit for the defense he's been playing.
Up four. Step back three.
Got it! And he was running back. He knew it was in. Man, it's big time.
Pistons only have one timeout. They won't use one now. Corner three. Ivy, no. Trace Jackson Davis rebound.
Yeah, Steph is saying, get away.
Steph playing the clock as well as the Pistons right now. And he will be fouled, and that'll be free throws.
turnover.
I was about to say.
Last night, more than Stephen Curry. Nobody.
Yeah.
And then from a leadership standpoint, as he misses that free throw, he went and did the post-game media.
Absolutely.
And that is not easy to do, as distraught as the Warriors were last night.
He put it on himself. He prides himself on being able to close teams out, so he hated the way that one ended with the turnover. But this is the greatness you expect from Stephen Curry. Look at
11-3 run. After that, Bogdanovich three, and Detroit had the lead. Now Burks missing that three. Durin will track it down. Burks down the lane. What a finish.
That was nice.
He's such a good player off the bench. And Pajemski going to use the timeout.
Having a slower start, of course, worked himself into a game.
Ball knocked out of bounds, and so the Warriors turn it over. And there's too much time for stuff like that.
It's a two-possession game. They just need a quick three and then another foul.
Do not give up a three. That's the whole idea. Play them outside in, and the Warriors will foul.
Stop that.
Don't give up a three. Hiding. Drop it to Durham. We still have a two-possession game. Steph will be fouled now. The Warriors have hung together chemistry-wise, but it's also, as Steph hits the free throw, let's credit Detroit. You know, you watch them, and we league pass, like we see them a lot. They don't lay down. They come, and Monty Williams and Steven Silas, Jared Jack, they have these guys given an effort every single game. And it's tough for Detroit. They lost the overtime one in Utah. They took the lead here against the Warriors in the fourth. I give the Pistons and their staff a lot of credit. That's a goal 10. I mean, 28 clutch games, and they're hoped to be 14-14.
You learn from doing. Warriors are getting a lot of doing with these post games.
They get it into Šarić, and that will do it. So the only way.
I mean, he can really get hot. I want to see him get a good rhythm.
Yeah, three straight 20-point scoring games as he sets up Grayson Allen with a good corner look, and Grayson with a payoff. Rotation tonight.
Yeah, without a doubt. And that's why somebody else will step up, without a doubt. But they call a foul on Devin coming off that screen. Oh, good.
The Lakers on Wednesday night. From the corner, another three-point deposit from Grayson Allen. Suns able to turn him over. Here comes Mezzi. Grayson got it.
Keep shooting it, Grayson.
Yep. Bull able to grab the offensive glass. Grayson with a look. Yes.
It's Grayson Allen. No need.
He's on a 10-2 start here to the quarter. And Brad had an opening, but passed it up. As the Heat again kind of played a little matchup zone. Grayson fires from deep.
Get nervous, you get it inside. You better get aggressive quickly, see if you can get that third.
Grayson resets and hits from deep again. Allen sets, fires, connects. Allen on the dribble drive says, I got more than a three-pointer in my hip pocket.
Hands there from J.O.
He is good, the master at knowing he can give, he can take fouls and it doesn't send you to the free throw line.
Beautiful inbound play. Nurk with the screen, backdoor cut, and the payoff to Grayson.
The Heat shot a dozen free throws in that second quarter.
Here come the double teams now. Grayson from the corner.
Wow, really?
Connection.
Really? I mean, all right, what, really?
Grayson from the corner. Got it! On the season from downtown.
Not often this year, the Suns.
On his mixtape.
Tatum answers and silences the crowd with a triple.
Yeah, that was a great answer.
Two-for-one opportunity.
Yes, sir.
Tatum takes it and buries it.
Man, he can heat up in a second
when he's on the floor.
Pritchard for three. Can't answer. Cornette again got a hand on it. McConnell saves it right to Cornette. Fresh 24. Tatum only needs 4 seconds and buries the mid-range.
Yeah, Halliburton had a terrible first quarter.
Tatum on the turnaround.
That is tough right there. That's an unstoppable move.
And now runs the break. Picked up by Buddy Hield. Tatum feeling it. Puts him in the blender. And scores. Get him in the weight room.
Indiana's making enough plays to think to make you believe that they have a run in them.
Tatum just cooks this
one. Then I see Tatum and said, maybe not.
Pacers have made a couple of runs to close the gap. The Celtics led by as many as 15 earlier. Look out.
Oh, can't blame the court on this one. Miles
Jason
Turner stumbling.
Tatum.
Oh, here we go. He's coming right at you. Watch out. Oh, man. Tatum is.
Now Mathurin draws the Tatum assignment. Good luck. That's 20 for JT in the first half. 4-point lead. Tatum against Turner.
Jeez. That's in your bag. All right, watch Tatum on this one. Doing a little bit of work. Watch the footwork right there. Sidestep up. Buckets. You know, I saw it work.
Smith steps out on Tatum. And here we go. JT's got 5 triples. Steps back. Give him 6.
Shaking his head saying, nope, it's that easy for me.
Tyrese Halliburton is 2 of 8 from distance tonight. Tatum against Mathurin. Oh, yeah. +1.
Watch Tatum on this move. Spins. Goes up. No, that probably is a foul. You got to be straight up when a guy goes into you like that.
Now Tatum. Neesmith picks him up at half court. Get the switch on to Toppin. Tatum peaks the shot clock. And buries another. Oh, JT chuckling on his way down the floor.
He Toppin takes his time. He's acting like he's getting downhill. There's the step back. So quick on that release.
Holiday hooks it. Horford somehow squeezes, finds Tatum on the step through.
That's incredible basketball right there.
Tatum tries another. Bucket!
Jeez!
Exclamation mark! This guy can't miss!
8 threes tonight.
Tate and Şengün and Brook Lopez, it's like a bowling alley. There, all 3 of them went down.
You see that little one-legged?
Right.
You know, that was just, could have been just a set shot back in the day. He turned it into a Dirk Nowitzki, and Giannis, once again, operating beautifully down in the low post.
They went up against the top defense last night in Minnesota. It was an interesting matchup to watch in that way. And there's the turnaround for Giannis.
That's what happened at possession.
Gets it ripped away, and Giannis just rips down the rim. Thank you very much. Much contact on him in the first few possessions, like here. But you know what? It resulted well. Giannis puts it away. In and out that time for Jabari Smith Jr. Here's Giannis. You see 5 white jerseys getting back. Giannis, a little hook shot.
Again, Bucks 3rd in the league and getting blown by when they're on defense.
Giannis right down the lane for another dunk.
You got to make something happen off the, you know, away from Giannis to get that defense kind of mesmerized, watching the basketball. Giannis is so good with his timing from throwing up against the wall and see what sticks. You know, just try something different.
You mentioned the minutes that Ajax got at the end of the first half. There's Giannis with that spin move. Takes the shot. Giannis with the rebound.
And advantage, take advantage of it.
And he does. Giannis with the right-handed lay-in.
These guys are much better with that short distance at the 3-point line from the corner.
Dame over to Giannis. He had 2 big threes. He's got another one here in Houston.
He found his spot. The question with Jalen Green, will he continue on his developmental trip?
There's an alley-oop coming out of that timeout. Pat to Giannis.
Excellent play designed out of that timeout. Pick it up. Just trying to get this spot. Aaron Holiday, sturdy, stocky, strong, built low to the ground, does a nice job preventing that.
Giannis up against Green. He gets another. To Thompson, who fakes the pass, short on the three-point attempt. Giannis full steam ahead for another two.
A little bit of a back shoot right there. Takes out Cam Whitmore and just allows Giannis a clear path downhill to attack Jeff Green, and Green wants no part of that. So Whitmore kind of late getting into the play. That's because Brooke. Relax.
Brooke with the challenge. Giannis corrals. 93-78. Marjon Beauchamp with the open look and hits it. Brooke gets a block. His first block of the night. Giannis looks it off. Marjon with another chance. Feeding Giannis. And Giannis comes over from behind. Şengün still has it. 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Tabari Smith Jr. drawing the foul.
Right here, you get another chance to keep the scoreboard moving after a great defensive play by Giannis.
Chris and Giannis working together. And Giannis fades it back. Clutch, 42 points. And here's Giannis. Bucks have got to hustle. Down by 7. Chris, not there. Giannis off the glass. Marjon picks the pocket to Dame for 3. Giannis with another rebound and put back. 48 points for Giannis.
Dry spell, shooting from 3 and from the floor in general. Here's Dinwiddie, draws 3, finds Bridges in the corner. He got it. 5 years, $160 million deal he signed in the offseason before the Blazers moved on from Lillard as Bridges.
Lit a fire under him because he still loved this game and loved to play and wanted to get back. He got back, and look at him now. So I'm so happy for him.
Well, and I think so often as Simons hits the jumper. Claxton, Bridges, Dinwiddie, Thomas, and Finney Smith for Brooklyn. Bridges cuts in. And you love this start from Bridges, 11 points in this first half. We've referred to the recent shooting numbers from Bridges, and many of you have heard them, but, you know, the last. A touchdown lead on this Sunday for Brooklyn. Here's Simon storming in and finishing. Possession alive. Simons. Gets Bridges on his hip and banks it in over Sharp.
Giving them an opportunity to win.
And it held Portland to 32% from the floor. Simons, that is a tough
with
finish.
His offhand.
Yeah. Simons with some haste. Will pull. And hit from 3.
You're collapsing the defense because these guys have been scoring individually.
Simons, floater. The touch and stopping on a dime. Pretty
like,
cool.
Like he said, the opportunity alone for consideration is I mean, we talked about it.
Wow. It's been that long?
Yeah. Crazy to think about, right?
2016.
Simons step back 3. Simons step back 3 again. Anthony Simons. Chauncey Billups just lights up when he talks about that young man. Bridges floats it in. 17 for Bridges. Bridges, you bet. Johnson wants it back. Bridges will fire. Hey! Brooklyn in front with some highlights over the last few possessions. Finish. Simons off the window. It's all out of sorts now. Simons, he got it. We have Sharp in the game instead of Claxton. Bridges, fearing, failing, and he got it. Grant dances around Sharp, left it short.
Great defense, great rebound. Allows your team to get out and run.
Like that, Bridges lays it in.
To create layups.
Gave the Nets the opportunity to deal with the De'Ron Sharp injury. Nets, meanwhile, have scored six straight as Simons floats it in.
He's in the rhythm.
Split attention here now for Nets fans. Of course, concern over De'Ron Sharp. And then here on the floor trying to pull out this victory. Claxton is hugged. And it will stay here.
Well, if you're Simon, that's a great foul. He was in no man's land.
Compromised
position,
yeah,
so if just,
you will.
Just foul. Take your chances.
2:34 to go in the fourth. Here's Bridges trying to escape Simon. Bridges gets free, floats it home. 29, make it 31 for Bridges. A 110-109 Portland lead. Simons has scored the last seven for the Blazers. Grant nearly lost it. Five to shoot. Simons sidestepping three. Back iron, no. Reef keeps it alive. Grant can't knock it down. Rebound Claxton.
You don't want to settle. Pick and roll. Get into the paint.
Smith,
kind of like that right there. But that's why you set the screen body on body to create a driving lane for your ball handler to finish.
A 10-2 Brooklyn run and a one-point lead. Simons has it deflected out of bounds by Johnson. 1:31 to go in this fourth.
You see here, Claxton getting in the way, Smith using the body extremely well to brolic for you.
Dennis Smith Jr. has been a part of the closing five for Brooklyn. 10 points, 7 assists for him tonight. Here's Reed, fakes the three off to Brogdon. Simons a deep one. Wow! Anthony Simons with his heels on the logo. And Portland back in front by two.
A lot of days playing with Dame Lillard.
Man.
Getting the work in.
32 for Simons. He scored the last 10 for Portland. Smith. Off to Johnson. He'll fire. Short. But a foul. Brogdon fouls Johnson shooting three. And it's three free throws for Cam Johnson. And Chauncey Billups is going to challenge this call.
Brogdon hits a piece of the ball on the swipe, and there is no illegal contact. Therefore, it is not a foul. It's been overturned. The challenge is successful. At the time of the whistle, the ball was loose. It'll be a jump ball center circle. Portland will retain their timeout and have the ability for a second challenge later in the game.
Claxton and Grant to jump it up. Nets win the tip. And they do get a new full 24. Here's Smith, pocket pass Claxton. The back and out. Bridges, a jumper to tie. It's good.
But we've seen the difference in Claxton now setting the screen as opposed to slipping the screen, because you're creating open shots for your guards when they come off.
Bridges been one of the best in the NBA this season in clutch time. Third most points in the league in games that are within 5 points under 5 minutes to go, and shooting it at 52% during those moments. Tied at 113. Shot clock at 7. Trap on Simons. Off to Sharp. 3 to shoot. Brogdon motors through. Deflected out of bounds. 1.3 on the shot clock.
And that,
which you could say, okay, there's only 35 seconds
but
left.
But you may need
you
it.
May need
you
it.
May need it.
1.7 reset to the shot clock. Inbound to Sharp. Nearly cradles it in. That would have been sensational, was not. Sharp was trying to foul Claxton. They did not call it. Johnson, way off.
Rebound saved by Finney.
Oh, that is a heads-up play right there.
Brooklyn basketball.
Great job by Dorian Finney-Smith there. Just heads-up basketball.
Finney-Smith's foot was out of bounds prior to releasing the ball. Therefore, the challenge is successful, and it has been overturned to Portland ball. Portland's second challenge. Therefore, they will be charged the timeout. They have the ability to advance in this situation. Game clock has been reset to 22.9.
They can throw it into the backcourt, and they do. Here is Simons. He has 32.
The double should be coming.
There it is. Bridges comes. Sharp into the corner. Grant. Still 11 seconds to go. Sharp left alone. Knows it's too early. Will make his move and lays it in. But the Nets have time. 5.5 to go. Sharp gives Portland the lead. 5.5 seconds to go. A happy or sad flight to Paris on the line. O'Neal gets it in. Bridges turning. Fading. No timeouts remaining. 1.2 to go. Simons does not get it off. We go to overtime. Nets strike first in overtime. Grant sizing up Claxton. Grant able to finish. Claxton the double-double after his 10th board. Bridges full out of steam. Lays it in. Puts the back.
Bridges with the backdoor cut.
I never had 40 against them.
Get it?
Yeah, probably.
D'Lo at 39. KD at 38. And Simons now has 34. Smith. With Bridges, Johnson, Claxton, and Finney-Smith. Bridges. Going for 40, gets rejected. Reith got a hand on it.
I got two.
Grant barrels in and ties it.
That's being 6'9 right there. because he was pretty much under the basket. Tough finish.
121-121. Smith. Off to Bridges. Bridges connects. There's the 40 piece. The first net to ever do it against Portland.
Like it.
And it's 123-121 Brooklyn. 2:10 to go in overtime. Brogdon. He got it.
He's a gamer, man. Malcolm Brogdon is a gamer. 1-2 Shooting 40% from three right now, but he relishes in the moment.
Yep.
Big make.
Now they got to set the clock back to 2 minutes because it does not just run while the ball rolls. Once you hit the 2 minute mark, it stops at a made bucket. You saw the possession before Dennis Smith letting it run wide, but it doesn't happen now. Johnson. No, he's been flat on quite a few attempts. Still 3-for-8 from three in this game, but his misses have been short. .130 to go in overtime. Simons by the back. Brogdon again. It's a 4-point Blazers lead.
After after ball movement and defense movement, and you get that with the big.
Nets need to stop here. Down three. Brogdon turns the corner and lays it in. Nice play. Johnson gets denied. What a rejection from Grant. Outstanding play drawn up by Jock Vaughn out of the timeout. Simons hits the free throw, struggling today. Mm-hmm. And it seems as if perhaps Jock had seen enough. Simons hits both. 7 points. Chauncey Billups, Jock Vaughn, Piers exchanging hugs. A remarkably disappointing loss for the Nets this afternoon in Brooklyn.
Getting it out, Magic had a good corner three look.
Ben Carroll rips it away from Johnson. Paolo with two steps, lays it in.
Ben Carroll doing a good job. Watch the active hands here, knocking it out. Johnson's hands, and then the smooth finish. David.
Atlanta will inbound the ball. The Magic on top, 7-0 here. Young fakes the three. Cross court pass and a three out of the corner by Bay is good. Young driving, scooping it up and in with the left hand. Curry, wraparound pass to Johnson, broken up by Bantera. One pass too many by Atlanta. Bantera will keep it and lay it in.
We've got a one possession game late in the first. Hawks playing a little zone the last time they changed back over, and now they're in man to man.
He'll drive on Fultz. Markel cut him off. Young. Cole Anthony stepped in there to take the charge, but Young pulled up just in time to float it in. Young, a step back two. Got it. 6 points for Young. He averages 27. Bandero at the foul line. Now Houston going to let one fly again. This one's good for three. His third of the night. Andrew back on top, 44-43. Young, little tiptoe through the middle, finds Jalen Johnson. Mancaro squares up against Johnson. Step back two. A beauty. Atlanta by 1-2-25 to play in the first half. Play Young, floating it over the seven-footer Bataze. Comes Atlanta again. Trae Young. No. Spinning it up and in, and a foul on Bancaro.
No, come on now. This is what you're afraid of when you play against Trae Young. There's not much there. That's got to be in the air. That's got to be a little crisper. Tried to bounce it over there.
Trae Young sneaks one in underneath Jalen Suggs. Bogdanovich. Capella knocked away by Bancaro. Taken by Suggs. Lopped it up for Johnson. Johnson puts it in. Anthony guarded by Young escapes. Anthony down the middle to Bancaro. The open three is good at the buzzer.
Powell's third in the game. He's now got 21.
Young. Underhanded toss by Trae Young. Bolts to Bancaro, thought about the three. Now drives and pulls up with a jumper. And soft touches it up. Paolo will drive. Pump fake a couple of times. Nothing there. Now he'll turn and fire. It's a beauty.
Four block shots a game with Okongwu and Capella out there.
Young for three. His first of the night. And the Magic lead by seven. Young. Count the basket and a foul on Suggs. 4 points. He averages just under 28 per game. There's the contact.
Yeah, but it's all initiated as an outlet in that corner, and knocked that one away.
Chuma knocked it away from Young. Young got it back. Young high off the glass and in. Collected by Goga. Bancaro, 3-point attempt. Got it. Just had enough momentum to carry the lip of the rim. Atlanta so explosive offensively, never out of it. Young to Johnson, Jalen Johnson from Trae Young.
Trae Young just getting downhill, straight line drive right to the rim.
Young guarded by Chuma again. His 3-point shot is good. Okeke hands it back to him. The shot clock is ticking down. Cole Anthony trying to cross over. Had it taken away by Trae Young. Cole knocked it away from him. Scooped up by Houston. One-on-one against Jalen Johnson. He spins to his left. Fakes, fires, got it. His money.
Basketball. How about this move by Paolo? Look at that quick spin. Gets to his spot. off that left leg.
They control the opening tip tonight, and of course the X Factor is the man with the plan and the ball in his hands right now, Kyrie Irving, playing for the first time this year against the Timberwolves in scoring to start tonight.
Yeah. All those guys.
Post up Kyrie over Conley.
That is assertive, Harp.
He's off to another good start.
To stop any hope of shenanigans for the Trailblazers.
Hey!
Down the lane, Luka lays it in, and with that, the Mavs back in front.
It's broken down, but he'll have a field day back there. Great find.
Open three, Jones got his legs into it. You'll love to see it. Here's Jones for three.
Well, Mavericks have so many guys that can create opportunities for other guys. Kyrie finds Jones wide open. Unless they're claiming he didn't have possession. I thought he did.
4 minutes into the game. Mavs in front by one. Three-pointer. Yes, sir! Kyrie Irving! 24 points, 9 boards, and 5 assists. And he just got a hand on the ball on a pass intended for Gobert. Jones saves it into Powell. Kyrie passes ahead to Green. Under the defense, pull up, nice bounce.
I like that decision.
After Minnesota missed 2 shots in the paint. Initial attempt at Gobert's follow-up, no good. Luka looking again, rolling, and a corner three. Trino over Cat.
Yeah, and all he's doing is taking advantage of a bigger player trying to defend him.
10 straight games of 25-plus points come to an end when Minnesota won big at Houston the other night. He scored 24 in that game, and they didn't need him to score anymore.
You don't see him put it on the deck that often.
Now Luka splits through 2 defenders. A blow by Kyle Anderson at the rim for the layup.
Man for an easy bucket. Lucas said he can do it as well, right around the defense.
Pass carried Hardy a little bit too far away, or not exactly in the right position where he wanted to shoot it. The Kyrie squared up to shoot it,
yeah.
And it's that sweet sound of string music.
By Minnesota, there you see the move from Kai on that dribble handoff. And well, in a game like this, that's what you need.
Yes.
Yeah, that must give Dallas a chance.
Hardaway, he had 32 in the last game against Minnesota. So one free throw, anybody on the floor could take it. And Kyrie, one of the very best in the business, is the one who takes it.
That.
Oh, what a pass, Powell! Towns got into trouble, but flipped it to McDaniels, who forced it up against Grant Williams.
Excellent job defensively.
And so Dallas comes back down the floor, trying to rebuild their lead, which it shrunk to 2, and Luka laying it in. It was 78-2 last year. Open three for Grant Williams. Right back at you. Response to what Mike Conley did. There was an exchange of words out there. Is Rudy going to poke the bear?
Oh,
inside Kyrie. Blender.
So much defensively as you take a look at Kyrie dancing through the defense. He just finished talking about the lack of aggression.
But that's the first points he scored in 6 minutes back in the game. Here in the second quarter as Kyrie does it again, slicing and dicing. Now Luka. It's a late clock Luka moment. And he delivers over Kyle Anderson. 2-second differential. Williams driving around Reed. Kick out Luka. He'll drive it through the defense. Late drop off to Williams to lay it in. What vision!
That's brilliant.
Playing their collective tails off, and then you have moments of magic from Luka like that. Jones' shoulder.
As if it was Superman's cape.
You know, he can fly like Superman. And Kyrie and Luka do their own Superman thing. Hasn't been looking to shoot the ball much tonight. 3 shots. 2 twos made of both. Kyrie in the paint again.
To go my vacation spot.
I mean, I would love to go to South Carolina.
Good pull-up. That's a...
Yes, it is.
That takes up the slack for yes. Minnesota.
The step back check. Luka nails it and the Mavericks retake the lead. Luka doubled. Hardaway finds a cutting Powell. He missed the dunk, but it flies all the way out to DJ. Hardaway cross court. Kyrie steps into the three and he drains it.
Doncic and Kyrie Irving night after night. And Kyrie is in that special place right now.
No doubt about it, Kyrie Irving.
Outside to Anderson. He screens for Conley. Pocket pass, bad one. Steal, Powell. Luka waiting for support and waiting for Kyrie to find his spot. And he found it.
The guy right now, Luka finds him in the corner. Squared away.
Lost by 18 last month. Oh, that's a tough runner.
Oh, you're making him do something he's not comfortable doing.
Yeah.
When you start talking about Alexander.
Luka, yes, sir! McLaughlin for his career, 34% from deep. And now Luka. Right back at you!
What? And he thought he got fouled.
It just makes you go wow so many times.
That's definitely a wow. Not many guys in the league can shoot a step back in that situation.
And he looks up.
He got fouled, baby.
Luka finds Hardaway. Hardaway, he needed it, and he hit it. That go along with that, but he has battled his butt off. And here is Luka. He's been pumping, and he goes up to the cup from Lukai. First, it was Kyrie Irving shooting sensationally from the outside, and Luka's exclamation point. He went 0 for 3 on shots in the first half, 2 for 2 here in the second. A response from Dallas, though, immediately right back with a three, Tim Hardaway Jr. The 9 in each of the last 3 games, the most rebounds in a 3-game span in his career, 27 in the last 3 games.
He has to work against Conley.
And he does work against Conley, and he scores against Conley. Now McDaniels is matched up on Luka. Luka couldn't beat him, so he'll shoot over it and make it. Long 2-pointer here in the fourth quarter of the game.
Hardest time to make shots is in the fourth quarter.
Yep.
In the clutch.
And especially against the number one defense.
In the league.
Dallas had the edge in the first 3 quarters. Oh, big miss by Towns. He's out there, by the way, with 5 fouls. So watch that on both ends of the floor. He just missed a 3-pointer. 24 in the game for Karl Anthony Towns. Luka doubled. Hardaway from Jones. 3-pointer is missed. And, you know, here's another thing that's got to happen. Somebody
has got to.
Yep, somebody along with Luka and Kyrie. Whether it's Hardaway or Jones or whoever it is.
You can put the ball on the deck as well.
Edwards.
That's what they're doing. They're attacking opposed to settling for threes here in this fourth quarter.
He is a devastating mid-range player and has learned how to use that glass.
34 for Edwards, 24 for Towns. Powell screening, Luka driving across the floor, inside to Powell, who turns and finishes with a foul that stops an 11-0 Minnesota run. Absolutely vital to have that basket and this upcoming free throw.
Something good happened for you.
You can still find a crease amongst the trees.
Put both those guys in foul trouble tonight by being aggressive.
Can't imagine Luka will be out for too long, guys.
Nope. Edwards missed a three, and that's how long he's out, Skin.
For the use it or lose it timeout from the Mavs.
Yes.
It's just getting quality looks. The 3-12 left.
The person in the most perilous position as it relates to fouls is Towns. He has 5. Kyrie staring at the basket. Jab stepping against McDaniels. A stare down three ties the game.
Fourth quarter.
Right on cue.
What did you say about him in the fourth quarter last year? The best in the business.
Best in the business.
It is tied at 106. 6 straight by Dallas. Long pass. McDaniels no good. Almost tipped in. Jones has it.
That's a win for the Mavericks, getting him to take that shot in that situation.
Especially tonight. He's 1 for 10.
Yes.
Now Kyrie around Towns. Inside block from behind by Towns out of bounds.
Out of contact after that.
Sure was.
Block.
Kyrie making his case right there, Hart.
12 seconds on the shot.
Just a stare down.
And you can feel it coming.
That little jab step. It's there's Kai trying to get to the rim.
Now it's Luka into Kyrie. Luka and Kyrie both have 32. Kyrie bottled up by McDaniels, lost it, but he stole it. He stole it from Gobert, and there was a reset of the shot clock too.
What a break. Play. That's a huge break for Dallas.
He has done so much tonight: scoring, steals, rebounds.
There he is again.
Corner three. Corner pocket. Kai lets it fly and does it again.
He's built for it, man.
He's built different.
He is built for this time of the game. He and Luka.
Towns for three to tie it.
Foul.
Yeah. On McDaniels, it's a foul to give, Skinner. First in the last 2 minutes, fourth in the quarter.
Talking about sticking with it, right? Look like he was going to lose that one. In his day, he goes right back and get it.
And then the three.
In the corner, locked and loaded.
Guys, I've got Kyrie with three steals and two blocks in this game.
Yeah, he's been everywhere. Very active.
Along with six boards, five assists, and 35 titanic points tonight. Maybe two more here. Oh, Edwards, what a defensive play. Kyrie's running down. 4 seconds, 3 seconds. A long one-legged three-pointer off the glass. It doesn't draw rim, but Conley has it anyway.
Great D by the Timberwolves.
Especially Edwards. Pocket pass. Here comes Gobert, who leaves his feet and throws it away.
Yeah, Edwards put him in a very bad way.
Hey, and Luka had some good defense there, meeting Gobert on the drive too, Harp.
He was way out of his element in that situation, catching the ball on the move, trying to make a play for somebody else.
Here's the play.
Great help.
I always say when you're in doubt, you shoot the basketball. Yeah.
But that's again, good advice.
Gobert wasn't comfortable making the play there.
Long pass to Powell.
Full Luka, shot clock.
Yeah, Luka coming to get the ball. McDaniels on him. Dallas leads the Western Conference leading Timberwolves by 3 points, but they still have a lot of work to do. Last minute, open three. Jones! Timeout, Minnesota. And they've been stuck on 106. Dallas has responded with 9 straight.
That's what it's all about. This is a heavyweight bout right here.
A Powell three-point play and two Kyrie Irving threes have been the run to tie. Towns, no good. Oh, and what a rebound by Derrick Jones Jr. Jones has his second career double-double. They've both been this year with Dallas. He had not had one in his first 7 seasons in the league, but he has 2 this year, and that was an ultra-important rebound. Now Jones up top! 555! It's cleared for takeoff!
Smart offense.
Yeah.
You get the ball to the middle of the floor, and Minnesota's defense from there, Mark, was scrambled. Him if he gets you in a bad way at 62%.
Kyle Anderson to throw in. Anderson, long pass. Oh, it's out of bounds. It's out of bounds. And it's Dallas ball.
I don't like that. Not a tip. I don't know what they were trying to do there. Clearly not the right thing.
Trying to throw the back shoulder fade. Ball's in bounds. Man, did Jones deflect that? I don't know. Foul in the backcourt. And Minnesota.
You mean the attempt to, you're talking the attempt.
Yeah, did Jones. So watch here. Oh, I don't. Did he?
But then Cat hit it. Yes, Cat hit it. He hit it last.
I think there's an index finger on there. 18 seconds. Has not been a great night for the Mavs at the line, but what matters is not what was before.
Yeah.
Can't live in the past.
No, you can't. You're playing the number one team in the Western Conference.
Yep. Love the MVP chance. Seconds. Luka made them both. 13 straight Dallas points. Edwards jams. 5-point game. Still 11 seconds left. Timberwolves out of timeouts. Conley fouls Hardaway.
Irving 35, Luka 34. I keep trying to put that 70. I keep trying to manifest it. They're 1 point away.
No, they're right there. When they needed to be, they were at their best.
Yes.
And that's what it's all about when you're talking your star players.
Tim Hardaway Jr., 10 points in this game tonight.
86%.
Yep.
For Tim Hardaway Jr.
Timmy spent a fair portion of the season ranked amongst the very best in the NBA in terms of free throw percentage. He made his first 27 free throws to start the year.
Yeah.
And he calmly hits those two. It is a feather in your cap this season.
Huge
to beat
win.
The Minnesota Timberwolves 25-9. They're off to the best 34-game start in team history. Irving saves it in to Powell after the shot was missed by Anthony Edwards. One of the best 48-minute comprehensive performances, if not the best.
Coming off of that loss in Sacramento. Remember, they trail by 23. They cut it to three. RJ turns, fires three. Is good for Barrett. On the ground, Wiggins. And it's batted towards the Raptors. It's RJ Barrett. Barrett right to the bucket, and it's a run of 7-0. Trace Jackson Davis, the rookie out of Indiana. Spent four seasons there in Bloomington playing for the Hoosiers. RJ muscling his way in. It's been so good, 5 feet and in. Raptors get another turnover. Lead pass, RJ running the floor. And the Raptors lead by 10. Gives it underneath. Jackson Davis. Shot doesn't go. Here's Barrett running the floor. RJ attacking high off the window. He's got 11. To you by Mary Brown's hey. Chicken.
RJ Barrett. Bring it.
Pirtle checks in for Toronto. RJ turns, fires, and that is his second made three. And he has 14.
Him go 23 seconds into the shot clock. Played hard.
Jemski's 0-5 from three-point range.
Another good shot here.
RJ Barrett's got 17.
All right. RJ Barrett, 17 points, a perfect 3-for-3 from behind the arc. The D lead to the O.
And a shot to tie it at the end. Barnes.
Great help defense there, 3-on-1.
Siakam to RJ. Pascal Mal in traffic. IQ open three. Doesn't go. Scotty on the offensive glass. On a kick out, RJ with time.
Dominating them.
Out on the run, Scotty B. It doesn't go. Quickly scoops it up. Pascal finds Barrett. Why not? Oh, Mississauga's finest. Schroeder quickly. Pirtle, Barrett, Siakam, RJ. Turns down the three, attacks the left, and it's good. He's got 30. Barrett now gets to his left and finishes. He's got 35. Strong.
Barrett, watch him right here. Going against the shot clock as well in the little step through there, using the window.
15 points. Let's see. Season high for him. Barrett's got 37 large.
Nuggets have had great success against the Pistons here at home. They've won 12 of the last 14 here at Ball Arena. Now Murray, he puts a three and he's got it.
And just like, you know, maybe the travel and everything has just wore him out.
Now Cunningham guarded by Murray. Cunningham, pretty good three-point shooter these days. Off balance, and Murray blocks it out of bounds.
Showing good hops here, Scotty. Jokic playing the facilitator. Got five to shoot. Murray around the corner. Murray all the way. Murray underneath. And it's good. The Nuggets equal their biggest lead, 4 points. Watson's been playing well late. Thursday had 19 points in the Warriors. Murray lets it go. Got it! Most of the first quarter this season. Now Murray. Pass it out. Reggie Jackson's got a good look.
And he nails the three.
Nuggets starters with 15 points. Now check it. It's the Detroit starters who have 15. Their bench coming in with 14. And Murray hits. They're Murray mid-range. Sarah Thompson come off the bench in six straight games. single digits, and the dunk is good as Murray now with 14. He said in the pregame presser, give a big compliment to the Denver Nuggets organization, the coaches. They're like the blueprint as Murray is away. They're like the blueprint for every other franchise in the NBA on how to build. Murray already with 16 points here in the first half. Pulls the trigger, got it again. Boy, when Murray's got his confidence going, Scott, he is a lethal weapon.
Right in front of your face. Pretty good defense, not bad by Ivy, just that little stop and quick pop. Utah gave up on him and his confidence, talking about shooting.
Now Murray tries it again, knocks it in. This is the most points Murray has had in a first half this season, 20. Putting on 20 points, gonna crank it up again, here he goes. Against Knox. All back, baby!
Bogdanović, stay out there.
61-57, Murray in the lane, got it again!
A little late on that.
Screening action for Murray. Over Dirk. Got it again. So Jamal Murray continues to sizzle.
His confidence, he was almost a beaten guy in Utah.
Peyton Watson for three. High archer. Got it! We were talking about the reliable three-point shooter. Got a reset for the 14-second clock. Murray gonna back down. Murray. And yes! 33 for Murray and the Nuggets. Ooh, now Murray underneath to DeAndre
Jordan, and down the hatch it goes, and a foul.
That entire play, watch his pass, just flips. The Murray just red coming off that screen a little bit.
Screen and roll. Whip it over, Peyton Watson, yeah!
2.4 remaining.
And a nice dish, another slinger for Jamal Murray. 108-85, we head to the fourth. You're watching Altitude. Stay with us. He's been out virtually the entire season with an injury. Now Murray against Livers. Murray one-on-one, backing in. Shoot, wait, the confidence going. That's 17 second chance points for Detroit. It's the one thing the Nuggets haven't done well tonight. Murray's in the lane, put it up and in.
Boy, really trying to find Zubac. Such good play by AD. LeBron, Drain, down the track. Look out!
Blocking foul. That's a three-point attempt.
Look out below!
LeBron going downhill with a head of steam. Paul George decided to stand in late and was too far under the basket.
Decides to take off from the dotted line. Ooh. And hammer one. Look at that, man. Didn't he just have a birthday? Didn't he just turn 25?
One of those. He's one of those. I'm not going to give him my real age. Yeah.
Lakers have two, so neither really preserved them much.
During that stoppage, to see what the Lakers set up as an offensive play.
Lakers up by one. LeBron using the window. Tapped around Vanderbilt there, stripped, taken by the Clippers. Of course, they'll give it right into the hands of James Harden. Paul George, this is his time right here. Working on AD. Paul George going all the way, put up a miss, trying to stay with it, out of bounds.
That should be Clipper ball.
Yeah, they're looking for help.
Now they say Laker ball.
Well, again, there's no chance for a reversal.
Yeah, you only get one of those. Shot was missed, and Paul George has it. It's on the hands of, oh, man, another closer.
But again, the officials working in unison, helping each other out. Still a one-point game. Reeves, Davis, three-point game.
Timeout. Clippers, that's their last. With it being a three-point game, they take out Kawhi Leonard at this point.
What's he doing?
He knows his team better than we do.
That is true. Nebraska number two. 98-95. You got Paul George. Down by three. 2.5 to play. George working on Reeves. Double for a moment. Three to shoot. 2-1. Man. Boy, the Lakers play pretty good defense.
There's Zoo again, though.
Zubac owns the boards. Oh, they foul Powell. They foul Powell. Torian Prince.
Shooting three.
He'll shoot three. Eight more shots than he has. He's trying to keep the good times rolling. Lakers trying to right the ship. So nobody in jeopardy of fouling out of the game at this point. Tied at 98.
Man, gotta stop fouling three-point shooters.
Well, the first one went to overtime. Davis. Reeves directing traffic. 10 on the shot clock. AD over Zubac. Rebound. LeBron had it for a minute. Taken by the Clippers. Now Harden into the attacking zone. 19 rebounds for Zubac. He said he was working on a 20-20. Paul George. Minute 44 left. Paul George trying to dance around AD. AD selling out. Going to be taken by George to beat the clock. It did not hit the rim. It did not hit the rim, but it goes to the Lakers. They'll say play on. Tied at 98, minute 25. Cross court, LeBron. LeBron looks to attack. He comes back out.
Oh, wide open.
Wide open.
Wide open. Those are the shots that you're paid to make. Now you got to rely on your defense not to give up one of those.
Harden. They give him the two. Rebound Davis. This crowd is roaring. Most are on their feet. LeBron James will slow things up a bit. Utilize clock. We're under a minute. Laker lead is three. Bumps into George. Three. Two.
Now with two.
It's one. LeBron scores.
They don't have any timeouts, so the Lakers got to make sure they're ready to play defense.
Harden. Paul George, they need a bucket right now.
You just don't want them to give them a three, though.
Zubac. They're taking all kinds of time. They're taking all kinds of time.
Trying to work for that three-point shot.
Harden got it.
The one thing you did not want to let them get is
Boy
a three.
Harden.
Now, though, the 24-second clock, I mean, the game, yes, the 24-second clock is off. Game clock is the only thing that's operable. 22 seconds left.
Here we go. 103-101. Well,
they've got an active defensive five out there right now, so the Lakers got to be careful with the inbounds pass.
And
then make free throws.
Backcourt, D'Lo. Whoa. They got a hand on it. Lakers only have one timeout remaining. It's a two-point game. That was dangerous.
That's very dangerous.
Frantic finish to this one. Lakers looking for their 18th win of the year. They're probably thinking about the count. And do they have to get it up?
Over to eight. Over.
Yeah, and where the count was.
Oh, wow.
Did they bail him out? I think they bailed him out.
It was close. Russ is signaling for a replay, and for a challenge, and they don't have any. That's the foul they had to give, so now they got to make sure. That 8-second count is still in effect.
Lakers do have a timeout, and they take it.
Good play by LeBron.
Wasn't it, though? And he goes, we'll take it there.
Yeah, now you can advance it.
He moved it up about 6 feet. So just let's play it out. LeBron, 5-second count is going. Torian Prince. They foul. So Prince will go to the free throw line. Again, no timeouts.
And it's always the first one that you think you're shooting a medicine ball.
Oh, perfect. You would think the Clippers might even. Well, you can't play that kind of a game, I was going to say. Come down and get a quick two.
Time to extend the game?
Yeah, but again, you have no timeouts. You got to take it the length of the court. Yeah. That's the problem.
Now the Lakers should just give up a concession, too. No threes.
Leonard, underneath, put it up, and in. 4.9. In for Reeves.
Now, again, you're in the same scenario. You need to have one for sure.
Right. I mean, theoretically, you're up by four. You could foul. That, ladies and gentlemen, is huge. Little pressure. It's going to go to Norman Powell with three, with two.
Out of gear.
This is for the tie.